No, not right now. He'll just fold. You know, and dump it. Might as well take the mic too.
Yeah.
Pass the mic.
Pass the mic,
yeah. I've chosen to take a walk in the wilderness and finish with Elf Fool's Day. Is that okay?
Yeah, okay.
Your name is Watt, eh? Not Watson?
Watt, that's right. That was a misprint in the paper.
Yeah, okay. All right, okay. That's what I thought. You don't mind if I ask you your age, eh?
No, I'm 30. I can't remember. I'm 37. Christ, I can never remember the age.
You're not in the school year.
When you're past 21, it's all the same.
It's all downhill from there.
He says 1 minute or 1 second.
Okay,
and, and then tonight, and then we'll play All Fool's Day. Not All Fool's
take
Day.
A walk.
Take a walk. Mm-hmm. Tell me about that just a little bit. Then we'll play the song. We'll come back, talk about the band, your band, and what kind of show we can expect tonight.
Sure, okay.
Okay,
no problem.
Short and sweet. And then we'll play All Fool's Day to end off.
What's your first name again, so I don't call you Roger?
Robert.
Robert, okay.
Yeah, Rogers.
Rogers, good. All right, Robert, that's a Scottish name.
Rogers, close
enough. Oh, Roger.
Bonjour tout le monde, on a l'honneur en tout cas d'avoir aujourd'hui dans nos studios, dans le cadre du Maximum Blues, un groupe qui va se produire ce soir sous le chapiteau à 8h30. Big George and the Business, on a le leader du groupe, George Ross Watt, de son nom de baptême, si jamais il était baptisé. Welcome to CUFM, George, and thanks for accepting our invitation this afternoon.
Bonjour, Robert. It's nice to be here. Thank you.
Okay. You were born in Glasgow, I believe.
Yeah, Glasgow in Scotland.
Okay.
And the year of 1958.
1958, so that gives you 30-something years.
Yeah, 37.
Okay, il y a 37 ans, né à Glasgow en Écosse. And from what I read, I didn't have much information, from what I read, you started playing professionally at 13 years old?
Well, not professionally. I was playing guitar from then until I was... I actually played my first band when I was 15. Professionally.
Okay.
I was too young to get into the bar, you know, but I was playing in bars when I was 50.
Okay, you commencé à jouer surtout dans des bars, dans des pubs, dans des clubs.
Oui.
Vers l'âge de 15 ans. Il a commencé à jouer à 13 ans, mais il a commencé, disons, il avait pas l'âge pour entrer là, mais c'est pas le premier qui se produit dans des bars à cet âge-là, vers l'âge de 15 ans. You played in Scotland, around Glasgow a lot.
Yeah, for the first, in fact, only since around about 1990 have we been really travelling. We've done a lot of work in Europe, France, Belgium, Germany, Switzerland, Italy, and also here in North America. This is our fifth visit to Quebec.
Okay.
J'aime Quebec.
Okay, well, that's good.
No, that's for sure.
That'll bring your people
that's
tonight,
sure.
There.
That's the truth.
À peu près en 90, qui a quitté l'Écosse, ben il n'a pas quitté l'Écosse, mais qui s'est mis à jouer à des endroits à l'extérieur de l'Écosse, comme en France, en Italie. Quels autres endroits j'ai... What other countries did you say? France?
Switzerland, Germany, France, Belgium, Italy. All around that whole belt there, you know.
Okay.
Right through the River Rhine there.
Okay. And so you've been, let's say, for the last 5 years, you've been a globetrotter.
Yeah.
In a certain sense.
In a certain sense, yeah. Okay. Absolutely.
Alors, dans les dernières 5 années, il s'est pas restreint à l'Écosse, il a voyagé un peu partout en Europe et en Amérique ici. What kind of music, on va lui demander les genres d'influence qu'il a eu dans sa musique, what style of music grabs you the most and, let's say, can we say, influences you the most? Mm.
Well, either music that turns me on at the hip, or music that turns me on at the heart. So, for the hip, it would be Muddy Waters, and from the heart, I suppose it would be Van Morrison or Ray Charles. That's my main guys. Jimi Hendrix from the hip and the heart. I think you'll be able to explain to the people what I mean by that.
Okay. Il y a un mélange de tête et de cœur là-dedans, puis on a entendu les noms, Jimi Hendrix, Muddy Waters,
oui.
Et les autres. And those are the musicians who inspired you the most, I suppose.
I would say so, probably Hendrix, Muddy Waters, Van Morrison, Ray Charles, Otis Redding also.
Otis Redding,
yeah,
aussi.
Very much, yeah.
Alors c'est surtout des bluesmen, si on veut.
Oui.
Ouais, beaucoup des bluesmen. C'est bien.
Tous les bluesmen.
Tous les bluesmen. Mais surtout ceux-là. OK. De ton disque, sur ton disque All Fool's Day, la chanson Take a Walk in the Wilderness, c'est une belle chanson, ça.
Oh, merci. Strangely, when I went into the studio to record that, it wasn't written. I just came up with it. I wrote it in about 7 minutes, but that's probably how long it takes to play, right? And I think I've always believed that the best songs just come out. I mean, you can't sit there all day and try and write a song. It just came, and that was it.
Okay.
You know, so.
Okay, so you, it's like an egg, eh? It comes up
yeah,
when it's ready.
Yeah, that was it. Yeah.
Okay, la chanson Take a Walk in the Wilderness, il l'a écrit à peu près dans la même période que ça a pris pour la jouer, dans à peu près 5 minutes. Puis c'était comme c'était prêt, puis c'est sorti tout seul. Il dit, il peut pas passer des heures à essayer d'écrire une chanson quand ça sort pas. Ça sort pas, mais ce fois-là, ça a sorti tout de suite. On écoute ça. Take a Walk in the Wilderness. Big George in the Business.
Thanks, Robert. That was painless.
Yes, I did. You list names, and I forget half of the names.
Oh, I know, because you're translating you each time, right? How come you speak such good English out here, then? It's, you said it's your native language, but were you Ontario at this
time? Well, my mother, you see, my father is French in origin, and he lived in the West, okay, where everyone speaks English, and my mother lived in Quebec. Speaks French, you see, she was English,
right? Okay, that's weird.
And she was a Frizzle, you know, from Fraser, Frizzle. Well,
okay,
So at home we spoke English.
Yeah.
Until I went to school, my father sent me to French school to start off. So I went, like, grade school, I was in French school, so I learned French.
Right.
And, but it's still my native tongue. When I went to college and university a little bit, Yeah, well, that's
the more the more time I spend in Quebec, the easier it's becoming, but very slowly, you know.
Yeah, it's like the only way is immersion, sort of thing.
Maybe replace your mic from your mouth.
Further back.
No,
or closer.
Closer.
Okay.
Okay.
Because when you speak louder.
Okay.
Speak.
Right.
Thanks.
See, that's a
Il était trop loin.
Ouais, c'est ça.
C'est ça. Moi, j'ai tendance à parler.